The Moscow Documentary Film Studios. Volleyball Olympics 80. Moscow, July the 19th, 1980. On that day, the 22nd Olympic Games in Moscow were opened with a gala ceremony. Each of the Olympic sports has a history of its own. Volleyball was born on the American continent late last century. Since then, the game has spread all over the world. 95 million people now consider it their favorite sport. Volleyball was first played at the Tokyo Olympics in 1964. The Moscow Games were volleyball's fifth Olympiad. Players, specialists, and spectators were unanimous in saying that excellent conditions had been provided for the volleyball tournament at the Moscow Games. A multi-purpose hall with 4,000 seats was built for the contests. Symbolically, it was called Friendship Hall. The small sports arena at the Lenin Central Stadium in Luzhniki, seating about 10,000 spectators, had been completely rebuilt. Two excellent halls were set aside for volleyball games for the first time in Olympic history. It made it possible to draw up a smooth schedule for the games with men's and women's teams playing every other day. The women's tournament brought together teams from Bulgaria, Brazil, Hungary, the German Democratic Republic, Cuba, Peru, Romania, and the Soviet Union. The Hungarian and Brazilian women's teams hadn't yet scored any resounding victories. And at times, their temperament and immense desire to learn all the tricks of the game were brought into play to make up for the gaps in their technical and tactical training. To be able to take part in the Olympic Games is not only a great honor to any sportsman or sportswoman, it's also an excellent tool of top-notch sport. The Bulgarian women's team made a good showing in Moscow. The keen, fascinating contests produced many sensations. Here's one of them. The Cuban women's team, the world champions, lost to the German Democratic Republic. It was a big surprise to all. And one can well appreciate the joy of the victors. It's not often that one can beat such a distinguished team. The game against the Soviet women's team was also a very tough test for the GDR side in their preliminary tournament. The Soviet team was considered the favorite in the match by right. The girls played confidently and skillfully. The outcome was predetermined by the high-class technique of the Soviet players. The USSR won the game. There was a deal of interest in the game between Cuba and the USSR. The Cuban team, the world title holder, needed victory to make the semifinals and to vie for medals. But hard as the Cuban team tried, the scales were never tipped in its favor. The Soviet girls outplayed the Cubans in every department of the game, so the Cubans dropped out of the contest. In the men's tournament, the medals were contested by teams from Bulgaria, Brazil, Italy, Cuba, Libya, Poland, Romania, the USSR, Czechoslovakia, and Yugoslavia. And there were surprises here, too. Poland, the Montreal Olympics, played Brazil. But past merits don't count. It's the stronger that win. True, the setback didn't bar Poland's way to the semifinals, but the Poles never imagined that they would lose the semifinals to the Bulgarians and drop out of the contest. There was keen interest in the games of the Olympic tournament. Modern volleyball is marked by higher speed, better teamwork, spiking, and skillful defense. Tricks earlier wielded only by a few have now become widespread. They're part of the technique of many teams. You won't see a player now who would only be active at the net and passive at the baseline. Sportsmen were busy preparing for the finals, the International Volleyball Federation held its Congress in the hall of Moscow University. The Congress endorsed the new charter and admitted new members to the Federation. The Congress also elected the leading bodies. Mr. Paul Lebeau was re-elected president. And then came the decisive hour. The women's teams from the Soviet Union and the German Democratic Republic met in the finals. They had already measured swords in the group tournament and knew each other well. The game was full of dramatic moments, and no one would have dared predict the outcome. The DDR team undoubtedly played its best game in the past few years. The girls increased the pace and were excellent in defense and blocking. And much more often than before, they spiked from short and shooting passes. Still, the USSR outplayed the DDR team in the first set to win 15-12. Yet the DDR won the second set with the same score. The third set was almost a disaster to the Soviet team. It was losing 7-13 at first, but the girls managed to win back 8 points to turn the tide and to lead 2-1. The fourth set. Thank you. The GDR is again in the lead, 5-0. The Soviet women put up a staunch battle for every point and managed to catch up. Their great determination was slowly but surely bringing them victory. Each player did her utmost, and all of them made up a close-knit squad to capture the Olympic gold. The USSR women's volleyball team became champions of the Moscow Games. The silver went to the German Democratic Republic. A big success for them, too. The Bulgarian team captured the bronze. Lord Kilanin, the president of the International Olympic Committee, came to watch the men's finals. The Soviet and Bulgarian teams are on the court. They displayed the best features of modern volleyball with its intricate combinations. See how long the ball is kept in the air. Leading players now tend to be jacks of all trades. Each of them is good both in attack and defense. The contests have shown that no team can hope to win without several top-notch players. We saw quite a few intricate combinations and a lead to a smash without blocking. Blocking a service. A reliable group block. Cannonball spiking. Lightning combinations, and desperate dives for the ball. The Soviet team won the first two sets. The Bulgarians plucked up all of their willpower to win the third set, 16-14. Coaches Vyacheslav Platonov and Todor Peterkov gave the last-minute instructions to their players. The fourth set. Here are some of the episodes of this contest. Go! This service may tip the scales. The ball hits the rope, and here it is, the long-awaited victory. The Soviet team was rightfully called an all-round champion. It came through the tournament without a single defeat, losing only two sets. Bulgaria placed second, and Romania was third. The president of the International Volleyball Federation, Paul Libeau, had this to say at the closure of the Moscow Games. We set up the International Volleyball Federation in 1947, together with Yugoslav, Polish, and French sports officials.
À promouvoir la création de la Fédération internationale qui a donc été fondée en 1947. Depuis cette date, progrès ont été.
Much progress has then. At first, we had 13 national federations. Now, their number is over 150.
131 fédérations et nous ne sommes pas arrivés au plafond de notre popularité, mais nous devons encore continuer de travailler pour que notre sport que vous admirez.
And being aware of the popularity of volleyball, we shall continue to do our best to make this sport even more widespread and popular around the world.
Introduit comme un des sports principaux dans le monde.
The Olympic tournament embodied all of the most progressive trends in modern volleyball. They were brought out by the prize-winning men's and women's teams from the socialist countries. Script Mark Torchinsky, direction Alexandra Rybakova, camera Yevgeny Fedyaev, Valentin Korsunov, Faik Kasumov.